Welcome to our review of the Groundhog Gambit, game number 6 in the Holiday Hijinks series of games from our sponsor, Grand Gamers Guild, who we have to thank for dropping off a review copy to us last summer.
The Groundhog Gambit is an 18-card escape room in a box with the theme of Groundhog Day, which falls on February 2nd here in Canada and the U.S., which is based on a Pennsylvania Dutch superstition about the length of the winter.
Now, the superstition states that if a groundhog emerges from its burrow on this day and sees its shadow, it will retreat to its den and winter will go on for 6 more weeks. If it does not see its shadow, spring will arrive early.
Now, oddly, though, this escape room game by designer Jonathan Chaffer has nothing to do with woodchucks. It's instead inspired by the very popular Bill Murray movie instead.
Welcome to our review of The Groundhog Gambit, game number 6 in the Holiday Hijinks series of games from our sponsor, Grand Gamers Guild, who we have to thank for dropping off a review copy to us last summer.
The Groundhog Gambit is an 18-card escape room in a box with the theme of, okay, we're kidding, we're just joking. So this puzzle game is designed for one or more players of any age and can be played in about 2 hours.
This is actually double the length of all the other Holiday Hijinks games to date. This game is split into 2 parts, which should take about an hour each. You can try and solve the mystery in one sitting, or you can split it over more than one night.
In the Groundhog Gambit, it's a cold February morning, and you find yourself trapped in Timely Manor, trying to escape while dealing with the result of the professor's experiments gone wrong. Will you be able to escape in time?
Just like the rest of the Holiday Hijinks games, the Groundhog Gambit is just a small pack of 18 double-sided cards with instructions on how to play found inside the resealable packaging. We didn't bother doing an unboxing as there really isn't much to see, and we also don't want to spoil anything.
Quality here is what we've come to expect from Grand Gamers Guild, with these games featuring clear instructions, solid iconography, good quality cards, and all the information you need right at your fingertips.
Playing the Groundhog Gambit involves opening up the pack of cards, setting the cards aside without looking at them, and opening a web-based app that will work in any browser, meaning it will work on pretty much any device from mobile to desktop.
Once you have the page up and select Start next to the Groundhog Gambit, the game begins in the form of a point-and-click style adventure. You draw a card which shows a room with some features on it that have numbers next to them. You start with the look ability, which you can look at things by hitting the look button on the app and entering the number of what you want to look at.
As you look at things around the room, the game will have you draw new cards, giving you new things to look at, tools which will unlock new actions, and presenting you with puzzles you need to solve. Each puzzle is indicated by a magnifying glass. And for each of these, you will need to enter your solution into the app.
Now, do remember that each magnifying glass signifies a different puzzle. You need to answer one thing into the app for each magnifying glass. Because we missed this at one point with this one, and we're really stuck. Because we were instructed to draw 2 cards, and based on the descriptions on the cards and everything, it's like, oh, there's a keyboard on the wall, blah, 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 enter your password. We did that, and we got completely stuck. Well, it ended up there was a magnifying glass on each of the cards, and there was actually 2 things we need to enter, and we didn't notice that at first.
Now, in addition to solving puzzles, you will unlock a number of different objects, which can be combined with the numbers on the cards in the way the look action you start with works. Now, these combinations will lead you to drawing more cards and potentially unlocking more tools.
And this reminded me a bit of the Coded Chronicles system from the Ops Escape Room games. Now, while we are going through this adventure, if you get stuck, the app does have a couple of ways to help. First off, there's an information button you can click that gives you access to a number of standard puzzle vase ciphers and other information. Useful for this specific game, you get atomic numbers and symbols for various elements.
The app also has a graduated hint system, where you just find the card you were stuck on and tap on it to get hints. Now, these start off just by making sure you haven't missed anything totally obvious, then letting you know what cards you should be looking at, and continuing until giving you the final answer.
You continue through the game using the objects you find, solving puzzles until you get to the end and finally escape. You're then presented with a final score and the option to send your play info off to Grand Gamers Guild, where they'll use it to improve future games.
The Groundhog Gambit is quite a bit different from all of the other Holiday Hijinks games. This starts with the estimated game length being 2 hours instead of 1.
Yeah, you're basically getting double the value here for the same amount of money, which is a nice touch. Now, that does mean you need to set aside more time. You're going to need a couple hours at once or split the game over multiple nights, which could be good or bad.
And all still with the same physical content you get in every other Holiday Hijinks game.
Yeah, you don't get double the stuff, double the game. Now, the next change is really the overall tone of the game, like the way this one plays. While it has similarities to the Birthday Burglary, where you have objects you collect as you explore, this one feels even more so like a digital point-and-click adventure where you're managing an inventory. Now, this is all handled on cards and through the app. This includes having elements where you actually, like, will find a tool, then go back to a card you explored earlier to now have new things to try the tool on. This was also gave you a great sense of exploration. Like, you kind of felt like you were wandering around this lab and trying out different things, which was quite fun.
Well, I suppose that's a mix of good and bad, depending on your view. While having your physical game be more point and clicky versus having more experiences with that same limited system, kind of taken give and take.
Now, the most impressive thing, though, is the way the same 18-card deck is used repetitively to present you with different puzzles and clues off the same cards. Like, I can't help but be impressed by the behind-the-scenes design work that went into this game, the Groundhog Gambit. Like, it blows my mind that Jonathan was able to come up with some of this stuff. Like, I've noted in previous reviews of Holiday Hijinks, so I'm always blown away by each game being different and how it plays. Well, this was like a step above all the other ones. I was just like, wow, you did this with only 18 cards.
Well, one does have to wonder just how much they can get out of 18 cards, yet they continue to impress us with what they manage with every game in the series so far.
Now, I don't know if it was the added complexity of using the same cards for different things, or something else, the fact it was double the time, that were more puzzles in this game, or what it was. But on our first attempt to solve the Groundhog Gambit, something went wrong with the app. Now, when using the app, you can back out for any reason, like open up another app or close your phone or take a break or pause it while people are going to the washroom, which is a nice feature. When you go back to the page where it has the app, you always get the option, resume or restart, which is also the way this game saves, right? When you finish the first section, it says, feel free to close the app. When you come back, be sure to hit the resume button.
Which is certainly normal enough app behavior and basically what one expects nowadays from any modern up-to-date app.
Now, while playing all the games in the series, I am constantly jumping out of the app. Now, this is probably unique to me because I'm doing it because we're reviewing these games. So I'm taking pictures of us playing and I'm getting a shot of Gwen holding some cards or someone writing on a dry erase marker, and I'm tweeting and sharing on social media, hey, look, we're playing this right now, right? That's part of what we do here at the Tabletop Bellhop. This was never a problem until the other day when I jumped out and came back and it started glitching on me. I'm like, well, I'm putting in the answer and we're certain this is the right answer, and we double check it's the right answer. And then it ends up the game didn't remember where we were. There's a history you can look at, and it's showing me the history about four cards back. And honestly, five puzzles back. Once we enter in the solutions to those five puzzles we already figured out, the game did continue. We were able to catch up and continue playing. But then we got to the chapter break. And like I said, when you finish the first section, it's like close the app and leave it. Well, we did that. Then when I reopened it, it was back to that exact same spot, now more than four cards back. And no matter what I did, anytime I hit resume, it started us at the same spot on the same puzzle.
Now, sadly, this is not unexpected and perhaps surprising that it took this many games to find a bug. And it's a hazard of mixing technology with board games, one of the many hazards that we've discussed on previous episodes about technology and board games.
Yeah. And I got to admit, at first, we were kind of wondering if it was intentional, right? Given the theme of the game, things jumping back, but it's not. The app isn't meant to reset to the same spot every time. Something broke. So to finish the game, we had to restart. We had to click the restart button, start from the beginning, which wasn't too bad because we already knew all the answers for the puzzles. And thankfully, we took a lot of notes. There were a couple we had to kind of relook at the cards and go, do you remember what this one was again? But it was annoying. And what I really didn't like, and I guess it's not that big a deal, but like this totally ruined our final score. So I have no idea what our final score would have been in this.
Yeah, as time is a real part of the score, you'd have to know exactly how long you had spent prior to it glitching in order to, you know, sit around and wait that long before you put in the things to catch up time-wise.
Yeah, and you'd have to also like ask for the same hints you used the first time. And if you entered any wrong answers, like all of that affects your score and it was all lost. Now, I got to say, this is the first glitch we've ever encountered with any of these games, and we have played and reviewed all of them at this point. I doubt anyone else playing is jumping in and out of the app the way I am. I doubt they're closing it and opening it and closing it and opening it. Our second playthrough, everything was fine. So I hope this was an isolated incident. Now, I did send off a bunch of information and screenshots to the publisher and designer, and they are looking into what happened, hopefully being able to fix it. And one of the bonuses of this being an app is they can do that. They can just update the app without anyone knowing there was ever anything wrong.
So hopefully it becomes even more rare for all of those who follow in our footsteps and play the game that we are suggesting still is worth playing.
Yeah, because honestly, except for that one problem, we had a great time playing the Groundhog Gambit. I in the notes, I actually put good time. I'm like, no, great. Like we're still talking about this one. This featured a really nice mix of different puzzle types, requiring different skills. There was math, there was spelling, there was wordsy, there was tracing patterns, there was pattern recognition. Like, there was just a ton of different puzzle types in this game, having to spot things and visual acuity. And then the whole system for collecting and using items was just more enjoyable. And of course, there was the fantastic twist, which I'm pretty sure most people can guess what that was already, was handled in an extremely smart way.
Well, as we've come to expect from Jonathan's games, now after working through them, that's, you know, a solid, play, enjoyable game.
Now, I will say my family was a little disappointed, especially the kids, that there wasn't really any reference to Groundhog Day, the holiday. Yes, there's a groundhog in the day, technically two. One's just like an image on the corner of a card, and there's another one you interact with, but it's a small thing in one puzzle, and like you're not playing a groundhog that's trapped in the lab, which could have been a thing. It just seems odd to me to have a holiday-themed game, but base it on a movie that's set on that holiday and not actually about the holiday. And my kids were just confused because they've never seen Bill Murray repeat things over and over. Though I guess it's worth noting, you don't need to know the movie. And, well, you also don't need to know what happens if Wyrton Willie the Fifth sees his shadow in a couple weeks.
Well, I think that while the name and a bit of the celebration of the animal exists, the origins and connection to the animal and what it means has generally been lost. Yeah. The movie now has a larger cultural connection than the actual ceremony.
Yeah, I guess that's true. I guess it makes me sad just because I remember, especially as a kid, getting up that day and, you know, waiting for the paper to see if Wyrton, in Canada, it's Wyrton Willie, if Wyrton Willie had seen their shadow. Overall, though, if you dig escape room in a box style games, I can't help but recommend the Groundhog Gambit. It is the most impressive of the Holiday Hijinks series. It's the chunkiest one. It's the most difficult. It features the most clever use yet of 18 cards and offers double the game length for the same price as the other games in the series.
And that's saying something since we have been impressed with every pack of these we've opened.
Now, if you're new to these sort of games, I'd be sure to play in a group at least, or maybe start off with one of the easier games in the series. This one is ranked 3 out of 3 and it is longer. And just to get you used to how things work in this style of game, the type of puzzles, how you enter them. This one is not easy to solve. We used multiple hints this time and even had to click on a full solution to figure things out. And we played a lot of escape room in a box games at this point.
So not the one you should start with unless you're already a pretty confident puzzle solver.
You can pick up the Groundhog Gambit directly from GrandGamersGuild.com, where you can get it as a standalone game, part of a bundle, or if you really want to save some money, you can get it in print and play.
When there, remember to use our exclusive discount code Bellhop, that's B-E-L-L-H-O-P, to save 10% off your order.
At this point, we've now reviewed every Holiday Hijinks game that Grand Gamers Guild has released. Be sure to check out those other reviews for more holiday escape room style gaming fun. I'll be sure to top links to each of them in the notes.